Approximately 8,000 years ago, a large-scale disaster occurred within the nation of Myanmar or Burma from a hazard that not many people know existed in the country, a volcanic eruption. This eruption originated from Mount Popa in 6050 BCE, involving an eruptive sequence which began when an intrusion of magma started growing in volume underneath the north-central summit of what was at the time a 1750-meter-high densely forested peak. As molten rock continued to intrude underneath the volcano, its increasing volume pushed a section of the mountain upwards. This process caused the northern slope of Mount Popa to become increasingly unstable until, finally, a landslide began. This landslide subsequently snowballed in size until suddenly the entire northern slope of the volcano was moving as an enormous debris avalanche at a speed of several hundred miles per hour. This landslide carved a horseshoe-shaped crater in the northern slope of the mountain with, depending on the specific source, between 1.3 and 3 cubic kilometers of rock going on to reach sections of land as far away as 11.7 kilometers from the initial slope failure. Simultaneously, the magma which had been building in pressure and volatile suddenly was no longer blocked by overlying rock, causing it to explode outwards in a manner similar to a Paleian eruption. As a plume of ash shot upwards to a height of 15 kilometers, voluminous pyroclastic flows raced out of the collapsed scar at a speed exceeding 150 kilometers per hour. Since two large blocks of landslide debris had by then blocked a section of the horseshoe-shaped scar, it much like a wall caused the superheated gas currents to be largely diverted towards the northwest. Incinerating everything in their path, by 4 minutes later, these flows had scorched areas up to 9.6 kilometers from the erupting vent, leaving behind as much as 10 meters thick of superheated rock carried by the pyroclastic flows. The eruption then quickly waned until ceasing altogether only a few hours later. In only 4 minutes, 100 million cubic meters of ash and pyroclastic flow deposits had been produced, completely devastating an area of 46.7 square kilometers. This eruption, which occurred, met the criteria for a volcanic explosivity index of a 4. If this eruption, instead of occurring 8,000 years ago, had struck last year, the death toll of such an event could have been upwards of 5,000 people. Although what I just described is the only known volcanic eruption to have occurred in the entirety of Myanmar in the last 10,000 years, there are unverified stories that suggest that Mount Popa may have produced a weak phreatic eruption in the mid-5th century BCE. But why exactly does this seemingly isolated volcano exist in the first place? The answer involves plate tectonics. To the west of the country, the Indian tectonic plate is subducting underneath the Burma microplate. However, this subduction is occurring at a very slow rate due to the highly oblique angle it is occurring at. Most of this collision's motion transfers to the Burma microplate and creates strike-slip motion, while only a fraction of it causes the subducting slab to advance further, allowing for partial melting to occur. As a result, while an active plate collision is ongoing, it is occurring at such a slow rate that volcanic eruptions are highly infrequent, but can still sometimes occur within Myanmar. In the case of Mount Popa, volcanism had been ongoing in the vicinity surrounding what would eventually become the modern volcano since about 800,000 years ago. Early volcanism produced low viscosity lava which formed a plateau around a village which is also called Popa. A volcanic plug formed around 50,000 years later, upon which today a famous Buddhist monastery is located. Mount Popa proper only truly began to form 360,000 years ago, creating viscous alkali-rich lava flows. A modern central peak with a fairly symmetrical edifice had formed by around 250,000 years ago, while the majority of the modern volcano formed by around 220,000 years ago. All recent volcanism has occurred on the northern section of the volcano, involving both the creation of a series of basaltic andesite lava flows, but also the 6050 BCE debris avalanche. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Tracy McCullough, for supporting this channel.